Always watch the video diligently. 30 times every day. Hello dear Matrixers, welcome to the Matrix with Jonathan and yours truly Shiva. Today's topic, very exciting. The blueprint. The blueprint may tell many, not so much, what that might mean. But it has to do with our immortality. Yes, among other things. So the blueprint is the best version of ourselves that one can activate during one's physical sojourn within one's incarnation. Exactly. And that's not just the best version. It's the perfect version. That doesn't mean the version you had when you were born, but the one before that. Practically the original version. How it would be if you were born perfectly perfect. Without a crooked nose, without a crooked back, without bad eyesight. This means that if you already had a visual impairment on the right when you were a baby, you wouldn't exactly have it. How do we come up with this topic? I had a dream. And it wasn't even a real dream. I was at an information level where my higher self sent me. And there I was at the blueprint level. And I saw it that every person has one. So the human being was in a black room and it was also a relatively dark figure. And this blueprint is really blue. And that's like a grid. The blueprint is like a grid that's wrapped around the human being. And that's where the perfect version of ourselves is stored. There is also the blueprint for life per se, the soul plan, the perfect soul plan. I have now seen the blueprint for the perfect body with perfect health. And yes, now it would of course be exciting to know, how do you get there? The blueprint lies in a very specific frequency range. Unfortunately, I was not told which frequency range that is. Otherwise, we would have created a frequency for listening and meditating to get there. Unfortunately, it didn't work that way, but it exists. Now, of course, the question is, why doesn't anyone know about it or why can't you just activate it like that? The dark ones don't want that, of course. If we had the ability to just activate the blueprint on everyone, then everyone would have super abilities and be super perfect. The pharmaceutical industry would go down the drain, as would the whole economy anyway. I think that's being withheld from us on purpose, isn't it? Yes, of course, when you come to the doctor and he says, well, how are you? 7,523 illnesses and he then takes an x-ray and it turns out, oops, everything gone. So that means the blueprint represents the optimal version of ourselves here. The body mostly, and as it should be optimally. All disabilities, ailments, health problems, illnesses, etc. would then have disappeared. So the blueprint is actually an optimal reactivation of all stem cells in the body. Exactly, and you can even see it in a relatively technical way. From what I saw or how it was shown to me, this was very convenient. You could just push a button. Activating the blueprint means I saw some sort of blue button there. You would press it, so it's really very technical. You press the button and Zach activates. And yes, I can actually think of a third technique. And if you have, for example, the full power of conviction that you know it exists and it is possible, then you simply say, I am hereby activating my blueprint, the source matrix of my DNA, and with the same intention and with the same power of conviction, like you would type the word tree into Google and expect Google to spit out something about tree. You don't think that if you type tree, it will show you about cars, so you firmly believe that if you type tree, Google will tell you about trees. Yes, the same power of persuasion would be needed to activate the blueprint, for example. I believe that our ego doesn't play along that well. I'd say the big doubter thinks, Well, I saw the blueprint once. I had a higher state of consciousness there, and there I saw all the alternative selves that exist or exist at the same time. All the Jonathan living in the various alternate realities just like that. And then I saw that one of these variations was the most optimal. So it wasn't blue for me now, I have to say. No, it wasn't blue. There wasn't a blue grid or anything like that to be seen either. Anyway, I've seen that this is really the optimal version that can move through all realities. Kind of an original self, I'd say. Well, it seemed to me like an original, even an original Jonathan. The cat's name is Woozle, and now you know why he is called Woozle. So the thing is that when the original Jonathan enters an alternate reality, he copies himself, sort of creates a clone of himself. And that clone then moves further within that alternate reality. And if, for example, the alternative reality is then changed again by the clone, it is the case that it then clones itself again, and because of this it can then appear over time that it bewitches itself with an illness or something, maybe through a specific one misconduct, in quotation marks, or by making a decision that shouldn't have been made that way. And if this self, this clone, then continues to act within this reality, for example re-enters an alternative reality with an illness, a clone is created from the clone that was a copy of the clone. And so the trick is, from a reality that you're in right now, from there, you jump back to that original self. Because this original self has no physical problems or weaknesses. Of course, I'm not saying that if someone was born with only one arm, that suddenly when he switches to the original self, the arm is there again. But it's possible. So I'm not saying it's impossible, but I don't know. Definitely possible according to Ramda. Yes, of course, but anything is possible. But I can't confirm if that's really the case. I don't know. So those of you would have to try it out to see if it's possible. Yes, anyway. So the blueprint is the most optimal version of the incarnation you are in right now. It's not like you can suddenly fly or pick up cars or anything. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying the most optimal version within the physical reality or incarnation that you are in and which you can then use. In order to put everything back, so to speak, back to the original state or to the original matrix of your own body. Perhaps, yes, Castaneda also has a nice term for it, which I think is great, so I have to mention it now. Yes, right, exactly. Castaneda called this repenting, the art of renewing oneself, namely, renewing the whole physical body. This means that all problems with the teeth would then be gone. You then have an original, healthy you again. And then we really came up with a lot of examples of what would happen if we activated the blueprint. You would have perfect eyes, perfect vision. Yes, that's right. Perfect body to muscle fat ratio. Yes, and all the toxins that you have accumulated over the course of your life, which are now floating around in your stomach or elsewhere, in your brain or wherever, would then be eliminated. Away. No more allergies? No, no. Well, there you can see what is possible with the blueprint. Now you might be able to get an idea of it, but getting the blueprint is tricky. By the way, you can also activate them partially. That works too. That means you don't press the button, the ultra button for the complete blueprint, but only for your hair, for example. Your hair should be young, again, fresh, healthy, blonde, I don't know what. Then, of course, there's the baby skin, perfect eye section. For example, I did this once. Guys, stop listening now, that's not so sexy. And adapted my menstrual cycle to the full moon for the perfect version. Then I thought to myself, should be good. I will do it once. Actually worked. I had my period and said that I would like to have it on the full moon from now on. However, the full moon was already, and then I thought to myself, can I do it? The ego, the doubter, talked between me, but I did it anyway because I was so firmly convinced that it would work. Yes, I will speak more slowly, and then I just activated my code. My source matrix code for the menstrual cycle, and then after a week I actually had my menstruation again exactly on the full moon. So it actually worked, and that was just this partial activation. And that goes for the whole body too. I didn't pursue it further because other topics were more important to me, but somehow it's pretty cool. Yeah. That's right, maybe hearing too. If hearing isn't that good, or if you're pretty much deaf in one ear or something like that, activating the blueprint would reactivate that. Or if you're sick, if you have cancer or arthritis, whatever, it would all just go away. You perceived it as blue scattering material, i.e., as a blue pattern, or as a blue body with a grid. Yes, the body glowed. It was really an information layer. It was a space that was not spatial. And the man was black. But you could see him. And this blueprint was laid on top of it. She was glowing blue. This is what the matrix grid looked like when one is astral. That's what it looked like. Yes, as I said, when I saw the blueprint, it was just one self among many. But it kind of stood out where I could just feel like that's the most optimal version to follow in this life, so to speak. And of course, we take detours in our lives because we have made one or the other decision. Then we go around to the left or to the right, a detour. Then go through other realities, and ultimately we come back to the level, or if we go to the right, the next time that you then stray from the path of the blueprint and ultimately maybe find your way back to the blueprint and the right path of. This original self. Well, I didn't believe it existed, really, until my higher self sent me to this level. However, Seth, for example, also spoke of the blueprint. Yes. So she is there. We have seen them. Yes. So it is possible to reactivate the blueprint. It really is like renewing yourself. In stem cell research, a lot is examined and researched and compared because people are trying to use the stem cells again. So that the copied cells of the copied cells and copied cells are led back to the programming of the stem cells. This means that there is already a scientific or biological equivalent to the blueprint, namely stem cell therapy. There's a lot of research going on, yes, and I don't know exactly how far they are now. At least for women who are pregnant. Exactly, those who are expecting a baby, the women when they are sick can heal themselves, simply by the babies producing stem cells which are then transmitted to the mother through the umbilical cord. And voila, we're not saying you should get pregnant. No, no, no. That wasn't a hint. It just shows that it's possible. So if you're being fed stem cells, in quotes, then the program or the programming of the original cells that existed at the beginning is reactivated. And so you can also transfer it to the blueprint in an analogous way. So we can work with stem cells on a physical level or activate the blueprint on a psychological level, which in turn would then reactivate all the stem cells. Do humans still have stem cells? Yes. Yes or? A few are still there. I think they're just not that active with us anymore. Yes, that means stem cells still exist in each of our bodies. And they're probably asleep there because all the copied cells are dominating, so to speak. I think with the activation of the blueprint, they go into action again, I guess. Yes, that's how I see it too. So if you get the blueprint, all the stem cells that are still somewhere in the body and are sleeping comfortably would be reactivated and would then just take over. Yes, and then you can imagine health ahoy. They would then reactivate themselves. And we found the topic very exciting. Yes, we will tell you about that. Especially since it is also a topic that has not yet been discussed on YouTube. Something that does not yet exist on YouTube. And we're probably the first. It's a pretty good tool for mastering the Matrix. At least I think so. It's a good gimmick for the Matrix on a spiritual level. You can't do that much with it. But perhaps you can achieve new health and new mental strength through this. And so we wanted to give you this recommendation for those of you who are ambitious and interested enough to maybe give it a try. First, find the frequency range. Yes, now the viewers are asking themselves, how do I get there? I ask myself the same thing. Either find the frequency range or we have considered two options. You always ask the questions. The questions are always answered with the answer dissociation? Correctly. And the second option, which I now have from Ramda, I can't tell you the whole thing now because it's just too extensive. But he has the Shiva dance and you actually draw a blue grid on your skin, for example on the diseased areas, with a blue felt tip pin and, for example, with the technique, with the spiritual eye, the guided meditation, the spiritual eye. Dot. It's just that you don't visualize the spiritual eye, but rather the word blueprint. And you always do this breathing technique with the word blueprint in mind. And that's a way of reality shifting. Reality shifting in the state where you just have an activated blueprint. We haven't tried it yet, but since this breathing technique works anyway, it would be a possibility to change reality in this way. With that breathing, you could do it if you are committed and ambitious enough. As it is, try it. Have fun. That's a good option. So in summary, as I understand it, you paint yourself onto the physical problem area, a blue grid, and then, once with the spiritual eye, except that you don't visualize the eye, but the word blueprint. Or you just draw a blue grid where you have the problem or where the organ is that has a problem and visualize it in meditation. Anyway, that works. What are you visualizing there? This blue grid on the organ, and imagine purple light, because the purple light is the ultraviolet light that emanates from the ultraviolet blue body that you are just seeing, and visualizes this ultraviolet blue light, which is from the frequency range, and this is visualized in this case on the healing. It is working. It's a long way from a full blueprint reactivation now, but it's part of it. In any case, yes, that's a start. It's a start. With which to start? Yes, I know of another technique associated with dissociation. You just concentrate on your blueprint and then say 3 times in a row, I hereby activate my blueprint. After saying it 3 times in a row, you dissociate. I don't know how many minutes at a time you're allowed to stop thinking. Not a syllable. As soon as you think a syllable again, or, for example, the cat appears as an image, or when is the next coffee or what you will probably do tomorrow, you have to start all over again. Say 3 times, I hereby activate my blueprint. 3 times. And then dissociate again. Start over and over again. Yes, and as I said, the last option with the strongest and most overwhelming persuasion there is, like just typing into Google Bomb. That definitely works too. But who has? Like, I'm supposed to go to Google, type in tree, and then I activated them? No, with the same intention, with the same power of persuasion as you type into Google Bomb and expect Google to spit out something about bomb. With the same intention, one says, I am now activating my blueprint. That should be enough. So you mean that one says it with this 100% matter of factness? Exactly. So how do you expect the search result on Google? Yes, exactly. Okay. Yes, of course. In any case, that is the case. Or you find the frequency level, push the button, the technical little button. And it works, yes. Really. I've seen it, but everything has been said. These two techniques that we have given you, you can try them once, over a longer period of time, as long as you can spark your interest in them. I have another idea. Just like I did, switch into the dream. One goes to sleep with the intention of seeking out the frequency range of the blueprint. I mean, I was shown it too. The higher self sent me there too, so why not you too? So go to bed with that last thought. You now go into the blueprint area and get lucid there, or dunno, try to activate it there. Yes, that would also occur to me now about the dreams. That's excellent. So that's about the blueprint. Yes. We would be happy if you would write a few comments about what you think of the blueprint or whether you have come into contact with it in any way. If someone can activate it, if someone can activate it for us, whatever. Yes. And then, of course, we look forward to your comments, and always eagerly click on the video 30 times every day. Exactly. Yes, I think that's it for today. Oh well. Bye and bye. Bye.